Let's now talk to Oriental Mindoro Governor Humerlito Dolor about the containment efforts for the oil spill. Governor, good afternoon.
Yes, good afternoon, Ron. Good afternoon to our fellow Filipinos.
Hi, sir. We do want to get an update on the oil spill in your area. Has it already been contained?
No, not yet. Instead of being contained, as of the report, at 5 o'clock in this afternoon, it has already reached additional 4 more municipalities. Yesterday, it was only covering Nauhan, Pola, and Pinamalayan. But as of this moment, oil spill has been sighted also at the areas near Gloria, Pansud, Pungabon, and as far as Rojas. With that, potentially it might affect 70 barangays along these coastlines and possible 26 marine protected areas. And the area is being becoming bigger and bigger. There is also sighting of oil spills around 1 hectare near Sibali Island. This is already part of the province of Romblon, our neighboring province.
Okay. How wide, how big an area is the oil spill now?
Before, it used to be, yesterday it was 6x4 kilometers, but now it's way, way bigger than that. From the place of the incident, it has already reached more than 34 kilometers as of 3:24 in the afternoon.
Is there a problem with the containment operation, sir? We understand it's the Philippine Coast Guard that's leading the efforts in containing the spill. Don't they have enough equipment, personnel to handle this kind of situation?
The Philippine Coast Guard, in the coordination with the local government units and the DNRS, is doing its job of containing. As a matter of fact, they have been spraying chemical for oil dispersant so that the oil will be smaller, but it will be easier to break. However, the spill boom is not yet installed up to now because of the weather condition, the sea condition, the waves are still very big, but they're doing their best to install it so that the spill boom will be able to slowly remove the oil spill in the area.
So they're having a problem with the weather, and that's why they can't install the spill booms needed for the containment. But at the same time, it's causing a wider area to be affected by the oil spill, right?
Yes. We are actually in constant communication with them, and we are really asking them to please install this at the soonest possible time that is possible so that it won't further affect the area which are not yet affected as of this moment. We're also afraid that if this will not be contained in the next hours or next days, it might even reach the center of the VIP, the Verde Island Passage, in between Batangas and Mindoro.
Right. And I was going to ask if what's the possibility or the likelihood of that happening, and now you're telling us there is a great possibility that could happen if the weather doesn't cooperate with authorities, if they cannot put up those spill booms to contain the oil spill. Okay, now those barangays, those municipalities and the additional municipalities you just mentioned, has it already affected the livelihood of the people there?
Since yesterday, we have directed our fisher folks not to go to the sea anymore because it's very dangerous. It's flammable, it's diesel and then it's oil. And so we advise them to avoid the area. Yesterday, it was only 6x4 kilometers, but now it's bigger. It's definitely affecting their livelihood. And as of this moment, I have discussed this with the DSWD, and I am sending a letter to them seeking their assistance to provide financial assistance to the fisher folks, which will be affected. And the DSWD regional director has confirmed to me and assured me that they will extend all possible financial assistance once we have already identified the affected fisher folks.
How about any help coming from the local government, sir?
Now we are preparing the food packs to be distributed to the areas. We have identified the initial 3 municipalities, and then I have directed the PDRRMC to withdraw additional sacks of rice to include the other municipalities. Yesterday, we have approved the PDRRMC resolution allowing this. And I have also directed our PDRRMO this afternoon to check with the Provincial Agriculture the extent of damages or potential damages so that we can declare state of calamity. The municipality of Polas also confirmed to me that they are intending to declare a state of calamity. And I advised them, finish the assessment of damages and potential damages and then finally come up with the resolution of the declaration, and the provincial government will follow soon.
Okay. For the three municipalities that are already affected and for the four other municipalities that may soon be affected, how many people are we talking about here whose livelihoods will be affected?
We're talking of thousands of people, not less than 3,000 to 4,000 people may be affected. Families, what I'm saying is families.
Not less than 3,000 to 4,000 families, sir?
Yes.
Okay. And the DSWD said it will be working on that financial aid on that. We want to also ask an update on the salvage work on the tanker. Has the tanker been taken out of the water?
Again, please.
Has the oil tanker been taken out of the water already?
No. The oil tanker was totally submerged.
Totally submerged.
At the depth of 460 meters. That's how deep the area is. So during our meeting with the tanker owner yesterday, they are thinking less likely they're going to salvage the oil tanker. Instead, the priority now is to remove the oil
that is
on board the tanker before it's found.
Okay, just for clarification, the oil spill, did it come from the cargo? Is it the fuel from the tanker itself?
Yesterday, it was only the fuel or the diesel, but it was confirmed yesterday afternoon. And finally, there's a final confirmation by Coast Guard this morning that it is actually industrial fuel oil. Only that the results of the water sample, the official result as to the chemical contents of the oil has been released. But we're expecting that the result of the examination from the water samples will be released either tonight or early tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
So that we will be able to determine what is the extent of the advisory we're going to give to the people. Temporarily, we advise our people not to consume any marine products that will be coming from the area that is affected by the oil spill. However, according to the report of the provincial health officer this afternoon, together with the toxicologist of DOH Mimaropa, they are advising that depending on the chemical contents of the oil that is present in the area, the effects or the diseases or the illnesses that might arise will vary, will be different.
Okay, we're talking about 800,000 liters of industrial fuel being carried by that oil tanker. So what are the priorities now? Is it plugging the leak from the tanker and its cargo, or retrieving the cargo, sir? What is being done about it?
We have already established our incident command structure together with Coast Guard and DNR. We have also asked assistance from the national government and the private sector for experts. We have advised all the Bantay Dagat and the DRRM officers to ensure that the people are advised of the situation and possible adverse effects. We also ensure that fisher folks won't go to the sea because of the danger of this oil spillage. And also the local government units are on the constant communication with the national government. Now, the salvaging of the tank, as I have said, is not the priority as of now, mm-hmm. but instead the removal of the oil. That's the priority, both by the owners and by Coast Guard.
Okay. Are the owners cooperating fully with this, sir?
Yes, very much. Since yesterday, they've been cooperating with Coast Guard and they've been cooperating with the provincial government. I have a personal communication with them since yesterday.
You've mentioned your fears of the oil spill possibly affecting VIP, the Verde Island Passage. How bad would it be if it reaches a VIP?
It is very bad. It will affect seagrass, corals. You know how important the Verde Island Passage is in the biodiversity situation of the Philippines and of the world. As of now, I think the wind blows going to southern part of Mindoro. That's why the oil spillage is going down south, not yet going up north. We hope that it will be contained soon so that it won't reach farther south, the two remaining municipalities, and it won't reach the north, which is the center of Verde Island Passage.
We're hoping for that too. Governor Humerlito Dulor, the governor of Oriental Mindoro, telling us about the worrying situation there in the oil spill area. Governor, maraming salamat po.
Maraming salamat po. Magandang hapon po.